Hi everyone, it's Jessica. Welcome back to my channel. Today I am going to decorate a special spot in our home for family game night to just get on the floor and get cozy and play some board games. You don't need a lot of room to create this space, so I'm going to show you how to carve out a little nook in your home for this type of fun. Here, in between what we have over here, a sunroom over there, and then this part of the living area, it has some really pretty windows, and it has this really pretty pendant that the owners had before. So I decided to keep that, and I am going to obviously remove that air doctor over there. We have a lot of air doctors. We just love having good quality air in our homes. And this china cabinet, which I recently renovated, and you can watch the video on that tutorial because I love the way it came out. I'm gonna remove a chair, probably leave one, and then I'm gonna make a gallery wall here. Gallery walls are great because you can really display your art and you can also give everything a vertical facelift. I bought this area rug, which is oval shaped, and I thought that that would fit nicely here. I got it on Amazon and I'm really excited to open it up and put it down, and that is going to be the foundation for this space. It's going to divide the space, giving it some texture and some softness.
Okay, so I'm going to place down this rug in the middle of this area here. Oh, and it is a circular. I thought it was an oval I had ordered. I forgot then I probably changed my selection, but oval or circle works really pretty in this space. It's not overtaking, it's adding some texture and a little bit of color because this has a little bit of gray and white in it. And it's still leaving some of the wood exposed here, so I like that. And this is going to be kind of the anchor for the space. And I'm now going to set up some pillows in certain sections that we can use to sit down and get comfy in when we play our board games. So just a couple of big pillows here to lean against a wall or against another piece of furniture, and that'll add more dimension and color. And I just positioned this chair over here that I had renovated that I think is just so charming. And it also flows with kind of the decor here.
So I have a series of picture frames from my old house, and I'm going to relocate them and see if I can put together a pretty gallery here. So I really like the way the dark frames look against the lighter color wall. This is the color Creamy by Sherwin-Williams, and I really like that neutral color and then adding pops of color to it. This is a picture that I painted, and then the picture frame I also painted because I wanted to give it a little bit more color. This might look good here, but I need to see what's going to be the right position. I also have this little mirror that I had renovated from a thrift store and used it in my kids' bedroom in our old house. So this might be another cute option. Here are more dark frames with pictures so I can just see and just try to visualize. I would suggest having someone hold them up and you can look at it at a distance. So I'm going to play around with the position and see what I like. By the way, I mentioned this in another video that where I was doing a tour of our house, but I just love our new curtains. They are just so beautiful with this like linen appearance and also the stitching and these little tassels on the end. And then they filter light so you can see that you can still have some sunshine coming through, but it does offer privacy at night, which I really like. I have found some games online on Amazon, and I'm gonna put links to them, but I'm so excited to play these games. And this is how I'm setting up the actual station for all the board games. I love using baskets around the house, and I've picked this big basket that is going to be decorative, sitting here in the corner. And then let me show you these games I found.
this one online that had awesome reviews. It's called the Genius Square, and it's for all ages. I think like it starts, I don't know, maybe 6 years old, but it seems like it's a lot of fun for the whole family. They can create a puzzle. And then if, I don't know if you guys have heard of Catan. I don't know if I'm pronouncing it correctly, but this is a junior version and it's a strategy game for the whole family. And you, I guess, build different shelters or, yeah, use your resources for it. So I am going to have a lot of fun accumulating games here for the family and just pick a big basket or a big container that will also serve as a pretty visual in your home.
I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart.